Welcome back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about word problems, and we have a word problem described above. The two congruent angles of an isosceles triangle are 7 times the first angle. Find the measure of all 3 angles. I normally start off all word problems with a picture if possible. In this case, I'm going to draw an isosceles triangle. The properties of an isosceles triangle are 2 congruent sides, and 2 congruent angles. As I read the question, we need to find the measure of all 3, and it tells us that the measure of the 2 congruent angles are 7 times the first angle. Well, since we don't know what the first angle is, I'm going to let x equal that first angle. So in that case, I have an x up here. And it also states that the other 2 angles are 7 times that first angle. So that means the other 2 angles have to be 7x. Another property of all triangles is that their interior angles always add up to 180 degrees. So using that fact and what I've defined here, we're going to solve for all 3 angles. So I'm going to add the first angle, which I call x, plus the 2 congruent angles, which are defined as 7x, and all that's going to have to be equal to 180 when I add all 3 of those angles up. When I add those, 7 plus 7 is 14, plus 1 is 15. There, I just combined all my like terms. So I have 15x is equal to 180. To solve for x, I need to divide both sides of my equation by 15. That means those 15s cancel to 1, and I'm left with 180 divided by 15. I see that I can divide, or I can simplify this fraction. Both numerator and denominator can be divided by 15. So let's work over here. 180 divided by 5. 5 goes into 18 3 times. 5 times 3 is 15. 18 minus 15 is 3. Bring down my 0, and 5 goes into 30 6 times. So I know that my numerator is 36. 15 divided by 5 is 3. Now I have improper fraction, 36 divided by 3. I know that 3 goes into 36 12 times. So I just found that x, or my first angle, is actually equal to 12, in this case, 12 degrees. Now, using this fact, I'm going to go back and solve for my other angles. So I have x equals 12. The other angles are 7 times x, or 7 times 12, which is 84 for the other 2 angles. Now I want to go back and check my work. Go back to the original equation, which is x plus 7x plus another 7x is equal to 180. We said that x was 12. So I substitute that in for each x that I see. Seven times 12 is 84. 84 and 84 is 168. So I have 12 plus 168. Is equal to 180, and I see that 12 plus 168 is 180, so I know that I'm correct. The first angle is 12, and the other 2 angles are 84 degrees. That sums it up for this video. Please stay tuned to our YouTube channel and also to our Facebook page. Thank you again for watching.